I like coconut, you can break them open. They smell like ladies lying in the sun. I like coconuts, break them open, they smell like ladies lying in the sun. If I had my way, I'd give a coconut everyone.
Welcome to this episode of Cooking with Francis Strange. I have a very special chef, author, friend, son from another mother with me today. Ricky Jordan, who I've known however long he is, I've known him 9 months longer than that.
That's right.
And he's gonna help me. We're gonna make quiche today. As in all of my other episodes, I've tried to show it's easier just to make it than to go get it and buy it. And so I wanna show you quiche. I've not been a real quiche fan all my life, but recently they've resurfaced. And they're great for breakfast, lunch, dinner. They last forever. And my neighbors like them. So we have been making quiche lately, and I wanted to show you, as always, just a sample. In fact, I had lunch with a friend today, and I was telling her what I was gonna do, and she said, well, I think I put tomatoes in it. I said, absolutely, that's the whole thing. You put in what you like, cook it the way you want it, and you're gonna love it. So Ricky is going to work for me today, and you're gonna beat those eggs.
All right. Can we add some flavor to your meal before we get started?
Like what?
Like I wouldn't even be on planet Earth without you.
I introduced Ricky's parents. So I'm so happy that he acknowledges that his presence on this earth is because of me. Very often, my children especially don't give me the credit that I'm due, but Ricky does. So, and that's where
put me
from
to
the
work.
Other mother. Okay, that's you exactly beat those. Right. That's how much cream you're going to just drizzle in a little bit of Worcestershire, Tabasco.
Okay.
And that's it.
All right.
Now, Ricky doesn't live here at the present time. He's in San Antonio promoting his second book.
Correct.
And it is called Welcome to the Jungle, The Curse of Clark High School. And which is, for those of you out of the San Antonio area, is our neighborhood high school. And he has lots of tales to tell, and weaving them together, and it's an interesting read and a great book, and he's here promoting it. So he was able to drop by today and do my hard work.
Well, I'm honored that you had me.
I'm just so
yes, I will do a good job.
Okay, beat those eggs with all of your might.
Okay.
I'm gonna be sauteing some, the quiche that I'm making today is bacon, mushroom, and spinach. So I have already cooked my bacon and cut it into small pieces. Now I'm gonna saute some spinach, and remember, this is gonna cook down to a half a cup, so don't scrimp on your spinach.
So now we're going to do.
So how many rounds of splashes do you
like? One.
Okay.
If I had my way, I'd give a coconut to everyone.
I'm gonna stop you doing
how many rounds of splashes do you like?
One. Okay. These mushrooms don't have to cook maybe as much, because they're still going to cook another 40 minutes. So we've got them started.
Is that going to be the timer on the oven?
Yes.
Now, were you dating Don at this time?
No. Don hadn't.
Because Don was going to school with
with
my
your
mom.
Yes.
And you were going to school with my dad.
Yes. Yep. So in 61, we were at SAC, San Antonio College, and your dad and I were, I forgot, Don was there too, your mom was at A&I. Anyway, so I go, I kind of think that might be a good match, you know? And it was.
You were right.
It was
you were right.
Darn good.
Yes.
they met in college and were together forever after that.
They met because of me. They just happened to be in college.
And then do you remember bringing your boys to Laredo?
Let's don't ask those embarrassing questions. I do not.
You don't?
But what I tell my children, I have had so many life experiences, I can't remember.
You can't remember all of them. I remember it because it was special. You allowed them to come on the sideline. They were water
Probably
boys.
Probably allowing them with the back of my foot.
Kicking them down to the sideline so they could be water boys at Dad's game.
For your dad's football team.
Yeah.
Now, was your dad the head coach there?
Yeah, he was. Hey, Martin.
The first layer will be the spinach. Now, the recipe that I got this from, that I modified, says to use frozen spinach and wring it out. I use fresh whenever I can. So even if it's covered up with ham and mushroom and eggs and all that stuff, it's just as easy. It takes 30 seconds. It's healthier. It's more tasty. You can add whatever flavorings you want. Okay, so now we're going to go with the bacon. So you can cut your bacon and then saute it, or cook it in strips. I will tell you, today I used, and I heartily recommend, cooking your bacon in the oven. It never shrinks. It stays flat, cooks fast. You don't have near the mess to clean up. So sometimes I forget that, but I didn't today. So.
And you don't get grease in your eye.
No, you just get it all over the sink, well, but that's okay. And now,
bacon is a Don Strange staple for pretty much
This isn't the sweet bacon that he does, but bacon's good with anything for anybody. So now we're going to spread the mushrooms. Okay, you need to start getting ready over there. You're not there yet, but
looks amazing.
It is. I'm not going to tell you. The good thing is, even if I live alone, but like I said, I have people. But you cut a slice out, put it in the refrigerator, you can eat it for 3 more days. Okay, so now about a cup and a half. I'm using cheddar cheese, any kind of cheese you want. I had an option of mozzarella. It's a little stringy. I would do a cheddar or something in that cheddar family.
You can put the mozzarella on top.
You could. Right. You're still gonna have stringy. You're supposed to put Parmesan on top.
Oh, Parmesan.
You're not gonna
That's
win. Right. You're not gonna win that argument. So you know. Okay.
Here.
Even.
Okay. Even disbursement.
Even disbursement.
Am I doing? I need reinforcement.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Perfect. I've never seen eggs disperse so
Thank you.
Perfectly in my life.
I practice.
That's the Food Network calling.
We lost some of our peppers.
Okay, that's enough. Now this is Parmesan cheese on top. So the thing to do is don't panic when things don't go right. I had this in the oven the other day, not this one, but a similar one, and realized I had not put the cheese in it. Pulled that sucker out of the oven, sprinkled the cheese, mixed it around, put it back in the oven, voila. Okay, now we're going into a 375 oven for 35 to 40 minutes.
Perfect.
So now that we have everything done, you did an excellent job.
Thank you.
I've never seen ladies be quite.
I have worked hard.
And the cream was added to perfection.
Yes.
And the pepper in the bottom of the bowl just gave it substance, you know.
How would you grade me?
Oh, an A.
Okay.
And your fruit.
Thank
That's
you.
Very important. So now we have this book.
Yes.
And it's your second book.
Correct.
And why did you do it? How did you do it?
Well, it's not my day job, but it's my passion.
Okay.
And so I love writing, and this book was a labor of love for many, many years. You obviously know all the events that kind of took place in the late 80s.
Yeah, it was interesting.
It was impactful on a bunch of different levels. And so for 30 plus years, it's been this nonstop movie reel.
And it needed to come out.
It needed to come out. And so while I guess the overarching theme, you know, I kind of stated it's murder and mayhem, fun and games in 1980-something, you know, the overarching theme kind of centers around some of the tragedies that we dealt with. And if you really look at it, I mean, two potential murders, numerous suicides, some awful accidents, and, you know, I mean, it just really impacted us all, I think.
Is there a good side in there, too?
There's a lot of fun and games.
Okay.
So there's a lot of football, a little bit of fighting, some first love stories, some bonfires, some beer bongs, and all the rest.
Reality.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we keep it real, but...
half of it took place at your house, for instance, and you have no idea.
Tell me something I don't know that I didn't plan.
But what put me over the edge to really get it done, and I remember the moment in time, we were fortunate enough to hook up with one of the friends that passed away and his family when we were living in Houston. I guess this was about 15-ish years ago. And sitting across from her and her talking about that loss, and while she's holding my son, you know, they kind of look like this young man, really, you know, I guess hit me in the heart. And I kind of committed that day, although it's taken a while, I committed that day that this story needs to get out and was determined to do it.
You know what's weird and wonderful? The same thing happened to me with the book I wrote.
Yeah.
It was a God thing.
Yeah.
One day I was on the treadmill at the gym, and Don had resisted writing a book about himself. He didn't talk about himself very well.
Yeah.
And it dawned on me that I lived that life from a different perspective, and I could write the book.
Yeah.
And then he didn't have to worry about hurting someone's feelings. I had to be I could be a little more realistic than he could.
Yeah.
But it was like you said, it was a God thing.
Yeah.
And from that day, my bend was to get the book written.
That's awesome.
And
it's a fabulous book,
exactly,
by the way.
Thank you. There will not be a volume 2, I'll tell you that right now. But
we're making volume 2 right now. It's just by video.
Yeah, right. But I know exactly what you're saying. And once that seed is planted, it doesn't go away.
No, it doesn't.
Until you don't have to finish it.
Yeah.
But you've got to commit to satisfying that feeling.
What's literally like 4 a.m. to 6 a.m. when this book was written. And my wife, my wonderful, wonderful wife, encouraged me all along the way. So really like two and a half years ago, I got really, really serious about it. Maintained that discipline daily and then went off to my boring day job.
Right.
But yeah, it's just, again, a labor of love, and I hope people enjoy it. It's real.
I think a side lesson people can learn is, you know, people pray, and I've always said, be ready for the answer and acknowledge when there's an answer. So, because you can pray and say, well, nothing ever happened.
You know, it's important to note, we were at one of the most prestigious high schools in the state of Texas at that time, for good reason. Wonderful people, wonderful teachers, wonderful administrators. This time that's kind of chronicled in the book, I think, speaks to just some of the unbelievable tragedies that just hit us during that time. But as I stated, there's a lot of good in here too, and a lot of fun. So
thank you. First of all, I want to thank Ricky and Rhonda for being here with me today. It's always more fun cooking with somebody. Please look into his book. It's everywhere.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Amazon, wherever. And thank you for being with us today. Like us, share us, whatever else
subscribe.
You're supposed to do.
Subscribe, buy our merch.
Pass us on. And come back for our next session. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.